Greetings. I'm just coming back after a long hiatus. This summer, I had a family member die, and since then, school's also started back, and I'm a teacher, and so things just kind of get out of hand at the beginning of the year in terms of my schedule and getting things done that I want to get done and doing things for pleasure that I'd like to do. And unfortunately, I just kind of got away from, you know, my fledgling YouTube channel. So if you're watching this, I appreciate it. I know I had gained some followers at the time I kind of started. And then by me tapering off, I understand probably a lot of people lost interest. But anyway, I'm back. This is a simple video about three things that have kind of entered my life through mostly being gifts to me unexpectedly. And those are the best kind of gifts, right? When you don't expect anything. And they're sincere. They're from the heart. The first thing I wanted to share is a tea kettle. It's actually just a teapot. It's not meant to be heated on the stove. But it was a gift from a friend of mine. We went to the mountains a couple weekends ago. We went to Blue Ridge. And she knew I liked loose teas. And we had talked about it and exchanged loose tea blends that we'd made and things like that. She also happens to sell kitchenware to companies so that they can then sell that stuff in their stores. This is something that she normally would sell or use as a demonstration for those interested in purchasing it. It's just a little kettle. Got a little lid. And then it's got a place for loose tea. And then it steeps in the pot. So I don't have to make tea cup by cup. I can make a whole pot and then take the pot with me to the table or wherever I am and have tea in multiple glasses. This is what I had been using, which I love. I'll just show you this. It's something I've had for a long time, but this is what I've been using. And she'd seen that I just had this one single serving cup, which is wonderful. I love this. It's made so that the strainer can sit in the lid, and any seepage, any, you know, tea that's left on the bottom is caught there instead of on the table. But anyway, I thought that was really thoughtful of her. And I love the color. My kitchen is shades of green, so I love that she even thought about that whenever she gave it to me. Totally unexpected. I'm just blown away by it. And I know it's a simple gift, but to me, I was just over the moon, excited about it, and I use it. I've used it almost every day since she's given it to me. I'm pretty obsessed with hot tea once the weather starts turning cool. The other thing that was a gift that was totally unexpected, I think it was Monday, because it felt like Monday anyway. I have a teacher friend. It's our art teacher at school. She had an allergic reaction to something, some insect bite or something like that, and she really needed to go to her doctor and get steroid shots. Hang on, let me fuss at my dogs. They're being rude. Okay, maybe that is over now, or at least manageable. This is the time of day when everybody in our neighborhood walks their dog, and then my dogs think that it's their job to greet them. They're really, it sounds like angry barking, but it's really like, if you could see them, their little nub tails are twitching and they're happy. And anyway, they just have awkward social issues. So anyway, my story about the art teacher, she had to go to the doctor. And when you are a teacher, you don't just leave in the middle of the day and expect your job to get done in your absence, right? Because you have 32 plus kids sometimes waiting for you to do something with them every day.
Merlin. I love you too, Merle. Goodness gracious. I know. I'm not mad. Goodness gracious. Wow.
You have to find coverage. You have to find someone else that's willing to come in and teach your class, or at least do an activity with your class that's similar to what you would have done had you been able to be there. There's like this meme on the internet that often says, or often comes around. I see it all the time. And it says something like, teaching is the only profession where you have to do more work to be absent than you would do if you just went and you were there, because there's all kind of planning involved. And that's you know, your normal plan, your normal lesson plan. But if you're not there, then you have to create something, some new lesson plan that can be done with someone else in the room instead of you. So anyway, it's a big headache. And then you have to find someone. It's really difficult to find someone to cover your classes. I mean, I've been in positions sometimes where I'm calling 30 people to find a sub. If you can't find anyone, then you have to ask another teacher in the building who has planning the periods that you're going to be out if they can come and sit with your class and do your lesson. And so I knew she was kind of panicked about the prospect of having to go ask people and finding out what people's schedules were in order to know who would be available at that time when she was going to be at their doctor's appointment. So anyway, I just overheard it. I was clocking in that morning and I said, I'll do it. I've got, you know, planning at lunchtime, so you go ahead and I'll take your class. And she just couldn't believe it, was very thankful, and was eager to get to the doctor. So I didn't really see her the rest of the day. I went and did her class. They were great. I knew a lot of the kids. I'd had them in previous years, and a few I have right now. And so, you know, it was not a big deal. It was very easy. It was fun. She's an art teacher, very artistic too. So anyway, I didn't really think anything more about it. This afternoon, I'm walking out the door and I see her walking down the hall towards me. And I thought, you know, maybe she was coming to see another teacher because I'm kind of way out of the way. People don't just come over to my little corner of the hallway to see me unless they have a reason to. And I really couldn't think of a reason why she would be coming. And she was coming to see me, actually. So I was wrong. She was coming to see me to say thank you. And she brought a token of gratitude for me sitting in her class and filling in for her that day. She teaches pottery, ceramics, and she made this bowl. And it's got beautiful glaze and beautiful texture. I guess you can see that, but really the camera's not doing it justice. And inside it's got shades of blue. It's really quite beautiful. If you could see clearly, I don't know, it looks like a face in the middle. It almost looks like a cat face, or we're wildcats, that's our mascot. So it could be a wildcat in the middle. And of course, she didn't do that intentionally. It was just the way the glaze fell into the, you know, ceramic. And so I would like to believe that it's a fox, which is my totem animal. But I'm just really pleased with it. It's gorgeous. She's obvious. I would say it looks professional, but that would be an insult to her because she is a professional. And obviously it should look like that because she's very talented. And it's blue, and then it's got teal, but it's also shades of brown at the top. And it's just very substantial, very heavy. Anyway, I'm just really tickled that she gave me this. I have no idea why she felt like she needed to do that for such a simple gesture. But I'm really glad she did because I love it. It's beautiful. All right. The third gift, which really is, apparently all my animals want to be in this video. Hey, darling. I know I haven't seen you since I've been home. Good. I'm sorry. Okay, my last thing really isn't a gift from someone else. It's a gift to me, from me. I try to get myself something that's seasonal and witchy every turn of the wheel. And so for this one, I really don't have a broom, a besom, that I like or that I consider to be, you know, a nice special object that's sacred to me. I have, you know, the cinnamon brooms you can buy at the grocery store that are made of, like, grapevine or, you know, some other kind of wicker wood, and they're tied together. They're beautiful. I have those, and I've made some that kind of correspond with each element, and I've decorated them accordingly with ribbon and, you know, seashells and crystals and things like that, and they serve a great purpose, but I wanted a practical working broom. I even contacted another witch who had shared a picture of her broom on, well, not a picture, she actually showed her broom in her videos on her vlog, and it was kind of an inspirational piece for me. I thought, I want something like that. And I I contacted her people who she suggested, and it's a really expensive shop. Not because I think they're overpriced, but it's a great quality thing. Everything's handmade, especially for you when you order it, that sort of thing. And I really just didn't want to drop that kind of money at the moment. So I kind of put it on the back burner for a while. And I started looking at other shops. And, of course, I like Etsy. I have a shop on Etsy. It's on vacation right now, and I hope to have that open soon. I'm going to do another video here in a minute about what's in my shop. But anyway, so I was shopping around kind of to see if there was anything comparable that was a little bit less pricey. And I found the perfect thing. It's a practical working broom, but it could also be your magical broom. And for me, it would be one and the same. I wanted one I could really legitimately use to clean my floors while simultaneously cleansing my space with each motion of the broom. And so, you know, just like I'm kind of interested in the granny witch tradition. I'm Southern. You know, this is my heritage, and using a broom to clean your house should be at the same time using a broom to clean your space. So anyway, this is a card that came with the purchase of the broom that I ended up purchasing. It's from Broomchick. She makes handmade brooms for ceremonial, for hand fasting, for practical use, cleaning your house, that sort of thing. And she has an Etsy shop. That's where I found her. And here's the broom. You can get different versions of this. It's got a wooden handle. I'm really not sure of the wood, and she wasn't able to say because a lot of them are different types of wood. This could very well be some sort of fruit tree wood. I really am going to research this and find out because I really want to know. I got a hook so I can hang it on my wall. It's got a leather strap. Okay, so that's cast iron. And you can choose the kind of broom you want, whether you want brown bristles, red or black, or a mix. And of course, I'm going to choose all three. Isn't this gorgeous? Handmade. Just beautiful. Beautiful kitchen broom. For my hardwood floors, they are aching to be swept with this baby. It's just got a good feel in your hands, too. I wondered if this would be too rough, you know, to use. I have all wooden floors. So, I mean, sweeping is something that I do often. I have an Australian Shepherd who sheds like crazy. And so I'll have it in my hand a good bit. And I worried that this would be too rough and coarse and it would, you know, wear on my hand or splinter or whatever. It's very smooth. So she's done some conditioning to this wood or sanding to it, but still was able to leave the bark on it to some degree and still have it smooth. I really want to say this is some sort of fruit tree, perhaps. I'm not sure. I will find out and get back to you. But anyway, I wanted to share this and give her some business, hopefully, because I'm just in love with this. It could not be any prettier, in my opinion. It could not be any more well-made, in my opinion, either. I wish you could touch it and hold it. It's exquisite. You can kind of see where she's attached. I don't know if I can do this. I'll show you. You can see where she's attached, the bristles here. And then woven around it to hold it in place. This is solid. This is super solid and tight. Anyway, that's what I wanted to share today, and I think I'll make another video here in a second, so you'll see me wearing the same clothes, and the other video is going to be about what's in my shop and that sort of thing, kind of Halloween-y as well. All right, thank you for watching, and thank you for everyone that's welcomed me to the Witchy community on YouTube. It's not something I've been doing very long, and I kind of got away from it right at the beginning as I was getting started, and so I do appreciate those that have kept in touch through Facebook and things like that. Have a happy Wednesday. I have to think what day of the week it is. It's been a long week already. Have a happy Wednesday. Blessed be.